Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Wednesday of the 29th week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass Presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphone. To you I call, for you will surely heed me, O God. Turn your ear to me, hear my words. Guard me as the apple of your eye, in the shadow of your wings, protect me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, grant that you may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. Our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation, as I have written briefly earlier. When you read this, you can understand my insight into the mystery of Christ, which was not made known to human beings in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. Of this I became a minister by the gift of God's grace that was granted me in accord with the exercise of his power. To me, the very least of all the holy ones, this grace was given to preach to the Gentiles the inscrutable riches of Christ and to bring to light for all what is the plan of the mystery hidden from ages past in God who created all things, so that the manifold wisdom of God might now be made known through the church to the principalities and authorities in the heavens. This was according to the eternal purpose that he accomplished in Christ Jesus our Lord, in whom we have boldness of speech and confidence of access through faith in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You will draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation.
You will draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation.
God indeed is my Savior. I am confident and unafraid. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. With joy, you will draw water at the fountain of salvation.
You will draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation.
Give thanks to the Lord, acclaim his name. Among the nations, make known his deeds. Proclaim how exalted is his name.
You will draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation.
Sing praise to the Lord for his glorious achievement. Let this be known throughout all the earth. Shout with exultation, O city of Zion, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel.
You will draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation.
Alleluia, alleluia. Stay awake, for you do not know when the Son of Man will come. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Be sure of this. If the master of the house had known the hour when the thief was coming, he would not let his house be broken into. You also must be prepared, for at an hour you do not expect the Son of Man will come." Then Peter said, "Lord, is this parable meant for us or for everyone?" And the Lord replied, "Who then is the faithful and prudent steward, whom the master will put in charge of his servants to distribute the food allowance at the proper time? Blessed is that servant whom his master on arrival finds doing so. Truly I say to you, will put him in charge of all his property. But if that servant says to himself, my master is delayed in coming, and begins to beat the men servants and the maid servants, to eat and drink and get drunk, then the servant's master will come at an unexpected day and at an unknown hour, and will punish the servant severely, and assign him a place with the unfaithful. That servant who knew his master's will, but did not make preparations, nor act in accord with this will, shall be beaten severely. And the servant who was ignorant of his master's will, but acted in a way deserving of a severe beating, shall be beaten lightly, only lightly. Much will be required of the person entrusted with much, and still more will be demanded of the person entrusted with more. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now today actually, if you notice, this is a continuation supposedly of the previous section of the Gospel of Luke. It so happened that yesterday was the feast of Saint Luke, so we had a special gospel for the feast day. No, but if you notice, Peter made reference to the parable, no, that was said earlier by the Lord. No, maybe just to sort of put this in context. No, because the first comment of the Lord again talks about our readiness. No. Our readiness, that we must be always ready for the coming of the Lord. Of course, a lot of this would think of the second coming, but a lot of it really is about death. No, when we come face to face with our Lord at that moment of moving on to the next life, are we ready? So that's the first point that we will reflect on. And then the second point is with regard to the parable that the Lord gives us in today's gospel about the faithful and the prudent steward, no. So we'll talk about stewardship, and then the last point is that I'd like to make you reflect on the question: what is the greatest thing that the Lord entrusts to us? No, what is it? What is that He entrusts to us? That third point. Siguro itong tatlong punto na ating pagninilayan ngayong araw. Una nga sa lahat yung babala ng Panginoon, no. Dapat tayo laging maging handa, no, sa pagdating ng Panginoon. At yung pangalawang punto na ating pagninilayan ay tungkol sa pagiging isang tapat na katiwala ng Diyos, no? Stewardship. At yung pangatlong punto, ano nga ba yung pinakamahalagang pinagkatiwala sa atin ng Diyos? First, about, no, preparedness, ano, or being ready, no, anytime that the Lord comes, no. I'd like to propose that, you know, you ask yourself, how much do I live my life in harmony? How much do I live my life in harmony? In other words, you know, we live our lives according to a rhythm, no? The rhythm of what God wants us to do, the rhythm of the task or the mission that we are supposed to live out, no? I think for me that is the best way to be ready, no? If we live our lives in harmony, the certain integrity of life that is expressed in a very harmonious rhythm of living one's life, no? I remember, I think I've shared this with you maybe at least twice over the last 2.5 years, no? About someone who told me he's afraid of dying, and then napaisip ako, no? And I told him, you know, when you live your life according to God's will or God's mission, I said, we will not notice, I think, our transition to the next life. That kind of harmony, no? That readiness to always return home to God when our mission is accomplished. That first point, siguro mahalaga na yun yung ano, no, yun yung buhay natin. Dapat kumbaga ay napaka smooth ng daloy ng ating buhay, no. Merong isang pagdaloy na aayon sa ritmo ng Diyos, no, at sa ritmo ng Espiritu ng Diyos. And then the second point is coming from the parable, no, the faithful and prudent steward, no. I think basically the message of the Lord is that when we are entrusted with something, we must live up to the trust faithfully and with constancy. In a sense, to do what we need to do what the Lord has entrusted to us, to do, in a sense, the duty that the Lord asks of us because of what He entrusts to us. No? And I think that is very, very important. No? Fidelity and constancy. I think both are very similar, no? But I think, in a sense, constancy deepens that sense of fidelity, of doing what God is asking us to do. No? That is the faithful and prudent steward, no? And sabi nga natin, 'di ba, ang steward ay isang pinagkatiwalaan. At yung pagiging katiwala ay tayo ay tapat na ginagawa natin ang ating ating mga tungkulin, tapat natin ginagawa, at hindi lamang tapat kundi merong matatawag natin na constancy, no? Yung constancy ay parang ano yan, parang masasabi natin na hindi magaling ngayon, bukas tamad. Hindi yung sipag ngayon, bukas wala. Pero araw-araw na ginawa ng Diyos, no? Ito na naman, babalik ka dun sa, ang kagandahan ng fidelity and constancy is, ito yung daloy, ito yung harmony na bahagi ng ating buhay, no? Ang pagiging katiwala ng Diyos. Tapos yung pangatlo, tuling punto, sabi ko nga, isipin ninyo, ano ba ang pinakamahalagang pinagkatiwala ng Diyos sa atin? I think the most important thing that God has entrusted to us is to share in the mission of Christ, to share in the mission of the cross and resurrection, to live that out in our lives. You know, one of the things that always amazes me is that, you know, not only does God forgive us our sins, but He invites us to be part of the mission of His Son. He entrusts to us what was closest to His heart. What was closest to God's heart was the mission of Christ to save humanity. And there is no greater thing that the Lord entrusts to us than this mission, to be part of the mission of Christ to save humanity. Siguro, pag nilaya natin yun, na ang pinakamahalaga sa puso ng Diyos ay binahagi niya sa atin, hindi lamang pinatawad ang ating mga kasalanan, kundi inaanyayahan tayo na maging bahagi ng pinakamahalaga at pinakamalapit sa kanyang puso, ang kaligtasan ng sangkatauhan. Let us continue our Mass and let us ask the Lord to grant us the grace to reflect on these very, very important things in our life, and pray that we may be able to become more faithful and constant followers of Christ. We place our faith in God the Father as we present before Him the needs and concerns of our lives.
That the Church may always show deep faith in God who guides world events, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That government leaders and workers may be honest in their work, and that they may always be ready to give an account of their work, not only before the people, but before God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That young people may be assiduous in their work and studies and keep on hoping for a better world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us now offer our prayer for our nation.
Panginoon ng kasaysayan, sa aming paghahanda para sa 125th anibersaryo ng pagsilang ng aming bansa, sabayan mo po kami sa aming proyekto na magtatag ng isang lipunang may tunay na kalayaan para sa lahat. Kalayaang nakaugat sa pagkalinga, hustisya at katotohanan. Kalayaan mula sa kahirapan na nag-aalis mula sa nakararami ng pagkakataong mapabuti ang kanilang buhay. Kalayaan mula sa gutom, kawalan ng tirahan at kakulangan ng dekalidad ng mga simpleng serbisyo sa pangangalaga ng kalusugan at sa edukasyon. Kalayaan mula sa panlilinlang, kasinungalingan at manipulasyon. Kalayaan upang maging mga aktibo at positibong tagapagbuo ng aming bansa. Bigyan mo po kami ng katatagan ng loob at inspirasyon na walang humpay na itaguyod ang isang bansang tunay na malaya para sa lahat ng mga Pilipino. Amen.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love we celebrate His death. With living faith we proclaim His resurrection. With unwavering hope we await His return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father most holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our prayer for an end to the pandemic and to rebuild our nation.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to ask for your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. Bless all those who help see us through the challenges the pandemic brought, those who tirelessly work to render genuine service, especially to those who suffered the most. Guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission and to end this pandemic. Heal all who are afflicted. Grant eternal rest to those who died and consolation to their loved ones. As we move forward, grant us the grace to see clearly, choose well, and act right in order to build a nation closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, faith, hope, compassion, and love. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not deny our petition, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us now offer our prayer for peace, joy, and hope for our world. Father in heaven, to you we offer this prayer in the words of our Holy Father, Pope Francis. We have so much to do and we must do it together.
In the darkness of the conflicts we are living through, each one of us can become a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. To us Christians, the future is a name and its name is hope. It is a virtue of the heart that does not lock itself up, does not dwell on the past, and not only survives the present but is able to see tomorrow. Bless our world, Father, with the peace, joy, and hope that the cross and resurrection of your Son, our Lord Jesus, won for us. For all those affected by calamities natural and man-made, for all those who suffer from the structural injustices of our time, amen. Our Lady, Mother of God, and Mother of the Church,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Marami pong salamat and have a good day ahead. Thank you.
We all can share to send these children and youth to school. For only 3,000 pesos a month, let a child from the most vulnerable communities finish elementary, junior, and senior high school. For only 4,000 pesos per month, give a dropout or an out-of-school youth a better shot at finding a stable job. Caritas Philippines appeals for your kindness, generosity, and compassion. This is our Caritas promise, that we will leave no one behind.